On 13th, now the next transaction on date 13 is cash paid to Mahesh. So the two accounts affected here are Mahesh and cash. So Mahesh is personal account. Mahesh is personal account. The rule of personal account is debit the receiver. The business is paying cash to Mahesh. So Mahesh is the receiver. So as per the rule of personal account, we are debiting the Mahesh, because debit the receiver. So Mahesh account debit, cash being real account, and the real account is debit what comes in and credit what goes out. So the cash is going out, therefore the entry becomes cash has to be credited. Finally, you write the entry as Mahesh account debit to cash. Mahesh account debit to cash, the amount being 6,000. The narration is being cash paid to Mahesh. Now coming to the transaction on 15th, which is machinery purchased, which is machinery purchased. So machinery is an asset. Therefore, we will use the word machinery only. And machinery is real account. So real account, when you are buying machinery, machinery is coming in. So the real account says debit what comes in. So as a result, we debit the machinery and you would have paid cash for it, and cash is again real account. So cash is going out, real account is going out. So we credit cash based on the rule of real account again. So your journal entry becoming machinery account debit to cash, the amount being 12,000. The narration would be being machinery purchased for cash. Now coming to the next transaction on 18th, which is purchased goods from Anita. On 18th, you purchased goods from Anita. Now when you see this transaction, there is no mention of anything, cash, etc. And it's not clearly stated whether it is credit or cash. So, but if you clearly read, it says that there is no payment of anything. So we assume it is a credit transaction. So purchase of goods from Anita on credit. The transaction is purchase of goods from Anita on credit. Therefore, we have to analyze, we have one account that is purchases, which is nothing but goods, and we have Anita, the other account. So purchases, that is goods, is a real account. So real account rule says what? Debit what comes in. So that exactly fits here. That is, goods are coming in, therefore we are debiting based on the rule of real account. Then Anita is personal account. So Anita is giver of the goods. So in personal account we have credit the giver. So we will be placing Anita in the credit, that is we will be crediting Anita's account. So the amount being 5,000. The amount being 5,000. Your narration would be being goods purchased on credit, being goods purchased on credit. Next transaction is on 20th, which is cash received from Mrs. Ramya. Cash received from Mrs. Ramya. So that means we have cash in this transaction as one aspect and Ramya as another aspect. So cash becomes real account and we are receiving cash. Real account rule of debit what comes in is applicable here. So cash account debit. Now if you see Ramya, Ramya is a personal account and Ramya is giving cash to the business. So she is the giver. So the personal account rule of credit the giver is applied here and we are crediting Ramya's account. So the journal entry ultimately is cash account debit to Ramya's account, the amount being 3,000, and your narration would be cash received from Ramya. Cash received from Ramya. On 22nd, the next transaction is on 22nd, which is rent paid or paid rent. Means you are paying rent. So the two accounts involved here would be rent and cash. Now, rent is an expense and it is a nominal account. And the rule of nominal account is debit all expenses and losses. So here it would be rent account debit. Now cash is a real account and you are paying rent, means cash is going out. The real account rule, that is credit the real account when it goes out, we are applying here and crediting the cash and the journal entry becoming rent account debit to cash and the amount being 1500, your narration would be rent paid. Your narration would be being rent paid. Now the next transaction is on 24 and it is stated as the transaction is postage and stationery. So when it is postage and stationery, we assume that postage and stationery is purchased. So generally small purchases we make by paying cash. So it is a purchase of stationery or postage for cash. So since these items would be used very fast, we give them or we account them as nominal accounts. So we can, here we have postage and stationery, which is a nominal account, and we are paying for it, means becoming expense. So the nominal account rule of debit all expenses, we apply and say it as postage and stationery account debit. Now when we are buying, the cash is naturally going out, cash is real account, so credit what goes out we apply and credit cash here. So the journal entry becoming postage and stationery account debit to cash account, the amount being 500 and your narration would be being postage and stationery purchase.